getting them on the phone. One woman used to go around all the houses, all the different, bang on the door, where you got a porn, see? And she'd have a pram, or a bassinet, we call it, pram, and how much she put on, and she'd come back with a porn, they'd give her 8p for going. Well, she'd pull all the parcels, have all the money, different parcels, as you want. Yeah. Those were supposed to be the good old days.
People don't realise that the poverty abound, that abounded. If you speak to young men today and to tell them what you had to undergo or what others had to undergo, they'd laugh at you. They'd say, I wouldn't do it, because they can't realise how bad it was.
But they'd have a good idea in Blendon Row off East Street Market.
I'm only 29, but I mean, since I've been married, I've only lived in slums. Since I've been married, and I don't think it will get worse since. So I mean, I can't talk about before the war. I only know what goes on there.
When they're sending rockets to the moon and literally putting men on the moon, that there's families there where three old families have got to share one toilet. Three families who will share one toilet. In all, that's 15 people sharing one toilet, which I think is disgusting. In the day and age when they're putting men on the moon, isn't it? And they should get things done right here on Earth before they start doing things up there.
But this day and age, I mean, let's be fair about it. Nobody should be infested with rats, should they? When we first lived here, my Michael now is the age of 12. He was frightened to go to bed at night for fear of rats. And they'd got in a woman's flat up the next block. She thought it was her cat. She had a cat, Roger. And she thought it was her cat, and it was laying in bed with her, the rat. My little boy went to the toilet at 7:30 one morning. He sits on the toilet seat and it's come out the hole in the toilet, over his legs, right, literally right over his body, and gone in the hole behind him. And then I heard him coming through my kitchen. You can literally hear him munching the floorboards. You know, they must be all underneath this floor, and they must be all underneath here. One morning the rat woman knocked on my door. And she asked me if I had any rats. So I said, no, I haven't got any rats indoors. I said, there's plenty of rats down the bins and out the back. So she asked me what colour they were. So I said, I don't know what colour they are. I said, you just see them flying all over the place, you know. So she said, are they grey or are they brown? So I said, I don't know. I don't know what colour they are. So I said, anyway, you're the rat woman. I said, you should go down and see for yourself what colour they are. She wouldn't go. So she said, I'll just jot down that they're brown. And that was it. She went away. But they play outside my front door. I opened up my door the other evening and there was four little beads looking at me, four little eyes. One go, I slammed the door again quick, you know what I mean? My husband came running out. They just hobbled. Because they got so used to you. See, this is it. They get so used to you going backwards and forwards that they're not frightened of you. Well, it's like one day the rat man from the town all came. He came around with his little bag full of rat poison. So he said, where are they mostly? So the woman that lived over there, she said, well, they're underneath that tin, there's a nest of them there anyway. She said, because I can hear them of a night, squeaking. So he puts his hand in the bag and on his hand was the rat food and he put it in. And it come out and it ate off his hand. Up went the bag and through the window he got them. He said, never seen nothing like it. He said, they're just tame. They just set it right from his hand. I can't keep my front door open. If it's late at night, I can't sleep with a window open. I have to shut my window as soon as it's getting dark. Winter or summer, the window's got to be shut because they climb through. I've got the rats out the window, the rats out the back, the rats in the block. I am literally surrounded by them. Looking for the one thing to be we ours and better ourselves. I know people to move on to estates that's come out of here and they say it's not like Blendon Row. They're not so friendly as Blendon Row, you know. And I believe this because I've seen them over the estates. They go in, they shut the door and they're in. They've got their bedrooms and their bathrooms. They think this is their life now, but I would like to move to a new estate where everybody was friendly, you know one another. Like Blendon Row, but newer, you know. But I know I won't find it when I do go.
See, but when we come over here, it seemed that everything was shut out.
It's finished. Well, when we come here, it seemed to be finished. Like the life we had. Well, we had a good life.
Tony Murray cantering through here on the Ruber. Car 13, we have seen it with a breast girth, a velvet night. This is a filly here by a four.
It's just broke up. See, all the friends we had are all moved out. See, they have to come out because it was all slums, see. And they're all moved away from us and we've got nobody.
Since the way they built these flats, you can't get no neighbours. You know what I mean? Like, you can't make friends. So you're isolated. Well, we're isolated from all the other people in this block.
When my boy comes up here and he says, I don't know how you can sit in here watching these four walls all day. He said, it sent me mad. And if anyone else comes up, they'll say, how ever do you sit here and do nothing? I said, I couldn't do it. So I said, to nowhere, you should always go out and always enjoy yourself. And this is what it's come to. It don't seem true. It's not right.
Here goes Coup de Fer. This could be the last.
I think it's changed according to how the world has changed. And of course, in those days, there was no television, was there? So you never see this for sale or that for sale. When they're up to there in debt, who do they come to? Their old mother, their old father, for help.
I'd like us all to live again as we used to. I'm not going to say our old houses, because the youngsters wouldn't live on them now. No. I'd like to see them all come back with us, all of them.
All you see now is youngsters wants to mix with youngsters, us, nothing. We're nothing now.
No.
Not if you're the mother, you're nothing.
We're past all fashions now.
Yeah.
Only put on a mini once and I was abused. Well, my daughter thought I was showing too much. She said, Mother, for God's sake, put a longer skirt on. You've got nothing to show now. Little did she know.
We shouldn't be here.
We shouldn't be here.
You just talk to yourself about that. I want to be here.
Well, the youngsters are married and moved right out, haven't they? Half of them are gone out of the neighbourhood. See?